Thank you, Brian, for giving a wonderful introduction. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the CUNY Forum on Buddhism, Peace and Mind, presented by the Asian American Asian Research Institute, or ARI, and sponsored by the Lam Shi Tan Memorial Fund. My name is Dr. Victoria Ying. I'm an assistant professor at New York City College of Technology in the Biology Department. Today, I will be the facilitator for the forum for the morning session, sessions 1 and 2. Before we begin session 1, I'd like to thank Dr. Brian Schwartz and the CUNY Graduate Center for providing us this facility for today. It's really a nice space for this event. The purpose of today's forum is to introduce lay people, particularly CUNY faculty and students, to the present-day Buddhism study, and to create a dialogue for all of us to understand Buddhism better and to share it among all of us within the university. Before we start with our first guest speaker, I would like to remind all of you that we will have lunch around noontime. Some of you have lunch vouchers. If you don't have a lunch voucher, do not worry. We will provide free lunch boxes. If you would like to buy lunch during lunch period, you may also do that in the cafeteria. We ask that you provide a receipt so that we can reimburse you up to $5. Also note that there will be streaming videos, audio podcasts for today's event, and it will be posted online at www.aaari.info or www.ariinfo. Now we will have two speakers for a panel discussion. Okay. The first speaker is Venerable Ji Xing, and the second speaker is Venerable Mang Kuang. Venerable Ji Xing is the president of the Buddhist Association of the United States. He will talk about Towards a Better Tomorrow, and Venerable Mang Kuang is a CUNY alumnus from Queens College and an abbess at the Buddhist Cultural Center in Boston, and will address the topic of meditation, a way towards peace. So we will begin with our first guest speaker, Venerable Ji Xing. Let us welcome Venerable Ji Xing.
Top Professor Brian, the facilitator, Dr. Victoria Ying, Venerable Mang Kuang, all members of the Sangha community, members, all members of my family. When I say all members of my family, I may need some explanation. Buddha always wants us to treat everyone as your father or mother. That's why in Buddhism, we treat everybody as a member of the family. We help them in any way we like. Incidentally, the English word family carries the same meaning. The word family stands for, the word family is spelled as F-A-M-I-L-Y. F-A-M stands for father and mother. I-L-Y stands for I love you. May I request you to stand up. Turn to your left, turn to your right.
You should stand up.
Treat him as a brother or a sister. Give him a bow, or would I give him a hug and say, brother, father, I love you, mother, I love you. And from today onwards, be the ambassador of, be Buddha's ambassador of peace. Be Buddha's minister of peace. Send the word of peace all over the world. I was very impressed by Professor Brian's speech just now. CUNY is actually preparing ambassadors and something that they will never see again. That is all contribute to that, towards that. I'm very happy that we are gathering here today. I think from all corners of America, And this is a very rare occasion. I always treat this as something that we might have been together before. We could have been listening to a Buddha together. Could be 2,000 years ago. It could be something like we, some time ago, we might be graduating from the same, could be Tuning University, I would say, 2,000 years ago. Then you pass, you move your way, I move my way, then today, well, we meet together again. What a coincidence. What a beautiful day. For that, I hope that from today onwards, we keep on improving ourselves. We can actually look towards a better tomorrow if we are committed. If we are committed. Now, can you please just close your eyes for a while? Sit up straight. Don't think of anything else, but concentrate on breathing for a short while. You know you're breathing. The moment you concentrate on breathing, you do not allow any other things to disturb you. Initially may be difficult, but if you try that for some time, you will be able to do it. Then try to switch that concentration into what do you mean by a better tomorrow? What do you mean by a better tomorrow? What do I want my tomorrow to be like? Think about that. Contemplate on that. And also think about the present moment.